Jack Richman is the founder of the action group East Midlands Knife Amnesty. He lives in Corby, and the group urges people to hand in weapons to get them off the streets. Last Saturday, they organised this march through the town to raise awareness of knife crime.
I have two young children, and that worries me as a father, that what their future holds for them if no preventative action is being taken place. We have kids running about killing kids, and what is the future going to hold for my children and the community's children if nothing's done about it?
Only last month, a 17-year-old boy was stabbed here in the Ripley Walk area of Corby. The victim survived. A 20-year-old man was arrested but was released with no further action. Northamptonshire Police recently launched a new initiative also aimed at discouraging people from carrying knives. Jack says he would like to see the return of youth clubs and activities to occupy young people in the evenings.
Beforehand, these would be classed as isolated incidents. They're no longer isolated incidents if they're happening once every week or once every month. And these are our children on our streets that are being harmed and are being killed.
In Milton Keynes, the family of murdered teenager Jay Fathers is calling for more of these emergency bleed kits to be available to treat knife attack victims. Jay was repeatedly stabbed by 21-year-old Callum Aylett. The family was at Luton Crown Court last week to see Aylett sentenced to life in prison.
As a family, you know, we've lost Jay, but all we can do is keep his memory alive by getting these kits out there to save other people. Jay's not the only person who's been stabbed in Milton Keynes and been killed. These bleed kits, if they were around, might have saved a couple of more people.
The campaigners want to do all they can to reduce knife crime, but they also want these medical packs to be more widely available to give victims a better chance of survival. Stuart Leith's ITV News.